Hey all, this is Piss and Sledge. This is my first attempt ever doing a Let's Play. I'm going to do one of my original favorite games of all time, pretty much. It's a little-known JRPG called Lufia 2. It came out in 1996, and it was published here by Natsume, who has a slogan of Serious Fun TM. So we'll see if it lives up to that name. I know it does, but basically, a few things to look out for in this game. It has some of the best music I've ever heard in a 16-bit JRPG, or pretty much in the SNES era. And it also features a pretty unique dungeon system. It sort of combines Zelda-type dungeons with JRPG turn-based combat, and it also has a little bit of Pokemon elements in it. So I'm going to start it up. Hopefully you guys enjoy this. This is my first attempt, like I said, so bear with me if there are any snafus or anything like that. Hopefully I can figure it out as it goes, basically, and I'll try to be as entertaining and informative as I can be. I did just skip a little cutscene that doesn't really matter, but it's fine. Here we got some nice menu music to start out the game. The main character's name is Maxim. He's a pretty cool dude. Not the brightest bulb, but pretty cool dude. And the game pretty much just starts out right away. There's no major cutscene. You have a bit of text. You meet your first friend here right away. Her name's Tia. And as you'll see, Maxim's a monster hunter. Nothing in relation to the game series that later develops by Capcom, but Maxim is currently being ripped off. And like every other JRPG on Earth, it starts off with the trope of, oh, monsters are appearing more and more often, so there you go. It's interesting to think what an ordinary job is in terms of a JRPG. A shop owner, yep. Just play Risseter on Steam for that. Pretty much pissed her off there. I can buy a few items here. The shop system is pretty intuitive. You can, you know, buy as much as you want. The inventory is infinite, I believe. But gold's pretty precious, so I'm not gonna waste getting anything early on. Starting town is Equid, I think. I'm not sure how to pronounce that correctly. Warrior business is pretty badass. Sundletan. Obvious foreshadowing. There's a lot of obvious foreshadowing in this game. Like, oh, have you seen that monster? It must be mythical, it doesn't actually exist. And then you go check it out in a cave or whatever, and sure enough it exists. You pretty sweet old man, let me know. Oh, and now he lets me know. So, like I said, it gives you control of character and pretty much scoot right away pretty fast. This is where the game sort of really shines, in my opinion. And just the dungeon design, the different puzzles, and the way you interact with monsters. The monsters in the dungeon are actually visible, and they have They have their own movement patterns based on how you move. So that it's one thing that really isn't replicated in a lot of other RPGs that really should be. Jellies are like Dragon Quest slimes, basically, and here you can enjoy the nice battle music. You'll be hearing a lot of this music. And you'll notice that it shows my experience to next level every battle, which is nice. I don't have to go digging through any menus or anything like that. And like I said, you sort of have skills like Zelda. You have arrow, eventually get a bomb, a hookshot. I'm gonna fight it anyways, it's just good etiquette to beat most of the monsters you run into right away. Here's our first very self-explanatory puzzle. They get significantly harder as you go, so there's quite a bit of difficulty ramp up here. And of course, as block-like puzzles, or column puzzles in this case, like Zelda. And old dude's pretty right here, the reset ability is pretty valuable. It basically lets you reset anything in a room. I think it resets monsters too though, so you have to be careful. That's one of the... See, it just sort of resets the puzzle. Just have to quickly do that again. He's just explaining the very basic elements of each dungeon, basically. You know, you got little arrows there you can normally jump off. So, do that in a bunch of areas. And there are rooms like this that you just have to defeat all the monsters. And depending on which direction you meet a monster, you can get a first strike or they can surprise attack you. Sort of like Earthbound in that regard. Now unfortunately, you might notice I'm damaged there. That's because level ups actually... They expand your max HP, but they do not refund the difference there. And, just like Zelda, you have a sword that you can use to basically cut every bush in the world. You don't get rupees or anything out of the bushes, so it's not too useful. The vines up here also can be cut. And sometimes they have secret passageways behind them and whatnot. Simple pot puzzle here. And I think that's the tutorial. It's not too bad of a tutorial. It's not very obtrusive and it sort of just lets you know what you need to know. I'll be fighting most monsters I can just because the battles are insanely fast. You'll notice that you can just be in and out of a battle in 2 seconds, so it's in general worth doing that. I can talk around to the PAM members, and they'll all sort of point to you, oh, you need to do that. So, looks like I have to go to Tia's house, which is the shop. Get a little date here. A little childhood boo. Making me food. Plop. Doesn't look too appetizing to me, but... And, Maxim's... in agreement that it doesn't look too good or taste too good, and then Tia's like, what have I done? These hands do nothing but destroy. Man, I'm fish. Such a cheerful evening. All you did was make me bad food. How is it cheerful? Getting into the deep questions. Why are you always in battle? Dude, I just love fighting. Exactly. That's what the Destined Hero always... he always has a natural ability, a knack, to fight. That's a trope, too. Ever since... Well, it probably originated from before Dragon Ball, but... Dragon Ball is what I always think of when the main hero is, like... obsessed with eating. Bad news, everyone! Well, what a Futurama. Looks like I already get my first conflict. Such a... an RPG world, having a door in a cave closed is the worst thing, because they're always so secluded. There's no roads. Towns are... always far apart. I've always wondered how normal NPCs travel around... Oh, and... in church, you can save, cure, lift. I can't remember what cure. I'm not sure what cure does, or lift. Lift might revive someone. It's a magic shop. You actually buy your spells, you don't learn them. I'm gonna just. Not buy any items and see if I can wing it. I love this overworld music. It's very catchy. I'm gonna just stand here and listen to it for a little bit. Makes you feel like traveling. You'll be hearing a lot of the dungeon music also. It varies some, but... Mysterious woman. My little knit lizard. See, a lot of fights are just... they're kind of worth going into, I guess. Nope. Okay, see, that time he surprise attacked me. Sort of an evil-looking mushroom. already starting to do a little bit of damage. I should have enough potions to be fine in this dungeon. So that button opened the bottom door. Okay, let's see. I can't remember what Chardonnay does. Yeah. Stores magic, which is nice. I don't remember it being too effective, but unlike Zelda, you can't actually destroy pots. Pots are, in general, a puzzle element, so you'll see this button lowers, and basically what you need to do is rotate. Got a nice life potion. I think life potions should increase my max health, yeah. Up to the maximum. They really should have just named their character Maximum. That would have been awesome. Why not live life on the edge? I was like, if that didn't actually kill it, I would have had to just quit my Let's Play right there and bow my head in shame. And, I think I showed this earlier, but if you, stick an enemy with an arrow, it makes it so that you can sort of walk by it. So if you're ever in a dire situation, you can sort of try and work your way through. You can see my stat increases here. Nice little bit of strength, agility, intelligence. I think MGR is probably magic resist. Yeah, I was gonna say that should be a surprise attack. Potion to replace the one I used. Escape obviously lets me leave a dungeon. I see a treasure. There's a lot of secret passageways in the game, so you can, even if it looks like you can't go through a wall, you can sort of check. It has sort of secret areas like Metroid. Zelda never really got too much into secret passageways. It's more of like, oh, I can see the crack in the wall there. Let me put a bomb. Use a potion. Can't go through a door, it normally means you need to figure something else out. I want to check the other stuff first. I'm gonna guess this upcoming door is sort of similar. There we go. Do much. I seem to remember there's some item that, or some button that I can press that automatically chooses auto attack to everyone. Those little arrows from before. down here. Yeah, I think I need to go through another one, another door first. There we go, that was a little more damage. I think this might give me another level up. Wasn't really paying attention to my experience. I'll probably use another potion after this, though. Oh. Oh. When the screen flashes, you can sort of notice that it's a critical strike. I don't think I can... I guess I do have to go through the room with a bunch of monsters. I thought there was something else I could do back here, but... I'll get a level up. 7 HP, 4 magic, strength, agility. There is a bit of variability in the amount of damage you'll do. It'll be like, right now it's probably between like 12 and 15 damage per hit. Okay, I'm keep forgetting B. B is sword swing, not X. I'll have to fight a lot of monsters to get my next level. Still give me the opportunity to here. Not even doing damage to me anymore. Another critical strike. Okay, we got bad enemies here. Yeah. Oh, I thought I was gonna get a sneak attack. Damn Zubats always escaping on you. Or multiplying and then escaping on you. Called his buddy in just to escape right afterwards. Jump down here. I'll take a risk. I'll go into battle. Hopefully I can take one out. Oh god. Should be able to kill. Yeah. Then I won't need to use a potion. This is the most you'll hear of the battle theme so far. There we go. Yeah, I think those guys can poison you, so they gave me an antidote. These things, this one heals you, this one restores your mana, and then that's a save spot. I think there's a boss coming up, and I'm not sure if I'm actually high enough level for it, but we'll find out. This is one of my favorite themes. I'll let you listen to it a little bit. Oh, I'm not doing much damage to this dude. Okay. I think I can risk not killing me. I think I'm normally another level or two up when I face this dude. He doesn't have any special abilities or anything, so it's not gonna be like he surprisingly does a bunch of damage to me. Thankfully, I have a bunch of potions. Okay, there we go. Level me up nicely. I like looking at all my stat gains. Got the key. Inner monologue. Saying lizard men are stupid. It's pretty, not kosher. Oh! Ah, right, her mysterious girl that always shows up in JRPGs. I can see the future. That's not creepy. Yep, that's literally what I was just thinking to myself. Red ball light. Sort of like the red comet in Game of Thrones. The gigantic swell of an attack on humanity. The translation on this game is a little bit wonky, but the characters are actually pretty interesting. This story doesn't go in quite the direction you'd think it does most by the end, so it has a surprisingly great story for 16-bit RPG. Gotta go collect my crew! I like the name Iris. Oh, you know what? I think what I forgot to do, I forgot to use my power potion, which increases my strength. Rookie mistake. I really have to stop doing that. Okay. Let's see, do I one-shot them? Oh, yeah. Living the life. If I can one-shot them, it means I'm gonna go into every fight. Free experience. Back here, little bugger. There you go. I one-shot him. Nope. No chance, sorry bud. Another charred newt. Uh, Oh shit. I fucked that one up. Messed that one up. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to swear. Oh, no, one thing I completely forgot to explain. The IP bar there on the bottom, the orange bar. Basically, some equipment has special abilities. It's sort of like a limit break from Final Fantasy VII. When you get damaged, that bar goes up. And lets you use your equipment's abilities. Get to listen to some of that nice music. So you get here, Sundeltan. Oh no! Maxim shows he's not too manly. Let's see, how much? That's a bit of gold. So like I was talking about earlier, oh, a mythical catfish? That's nonsense! And of course, you know, it's going to be a giant catfish. I'll check out the shop first. So you can sort of see the stat increases, and then when he's sitting down, it means he can't have it, or can't equip it. Yeah, so you can see on the right, or here, you can see on the bottom right there, it has an IP ability. So it might be a little weaker than the dagger, 8 attack, but it has an IP ability. So I think I'll get that, and we'll see what that IP ability is. No. Clearly the better investment is a small shield. It's just cheaper than the cap and gives me the same... I guess I'll get hide armor. Then I might go kill some things outside and get 15 gold for the, There are random encounters on the world map. Actually, isn't a chalkboard a shield? It might be really crappy, but... Nah, I can't use it. Blue jellies now. That's how you know we're really getting up there. This is why I need that shield, so blue jellies can't deal a bunch of damage to me. You can see it sort of automatically equips when you do that. And let's go into the equipment menu. You can sort of see there's actually the option to remove all, to do strongest, which of course I already have on. So that's sort of cool. Instead of like trying to go through all your items, you can just say, I want my strongest, and that'll be good. Save up here. then go do some detective work on where the earthquakes are coming from. I'm gonna go search the rest of the building. Yeah, I don't think you can... It's not one of those games where you can search barrels and chests and whatnot for, items. This must be the T-spot that, that girl was talking about. And that must be the girl. And, so I'm guessing the green tea is not something I can take with me. I'm not sure what ATP is in the game. I know what it is in real life, but... Well, actually, I can't even... It's like a Cito try something... Yeah, I'm just gonna embarrass myself trying to remember that. So what makes your muscles sore, though? Raise the water level. I don't think it's gonna be a Zelda Ocarina of Time water dungeon here though. But... I just like shooting things with arrows to make them feel uncomfortable. Watch critical hit. I'm almost level. What was it, 6? So I'm gonna... So their health is somewhere in between 18 and 25. Nope, they still do damage to me. Oh well. Battles in this game don't ever get too difficult, especially since your main character can heal, or has an ability to heal later on. Little frog thing. Bird thing. That. If you search around, there's normally at least one per dungeon of those. Got an eagle here. And doing more damage than the boss did last game. Or last time. Mosquito. They got the correct way to spell a beetle. For the longest time in my life, I thought the correct way to spell beetle was B-E-A-T-L-E-S because of the Beatles. Did not realize it was a pun. Got a little baby frog. Okay, I see how it is, baby frog. Dead now, though. Yeah, I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly, it's just the order I killed them in, which was... Yep. Spider again. I would not like to meet that spider. Oh shit. Poisoning me. Thunder blast. If I remember correctly, the thunder blast is actually pretty useful against a boss, so insect crush. remember if it's better. Oh. Oh, that's stronger than... stronger than the battle knife, so I guess I'll... is that... let's see if this cures my poison. It does not. Hopefully I got that antidote. Yeah. Holy balls. Yeah, the insect crush does extra damage, I guess, against insects, obviously. Wonder. Okay. And it just does more damage against them, everyone, so. So these probably have 25 health. Between 23 and 26 at least. See ya! Whoa. Yeah, you're full health already, bud. So, this probably... You'll see what... yeah, it makes me fall through the floor. I was in a surprise attack, are you kidding me? They give me plenty of experience and gold. Minutes. I'm killing it. Not quite a speedrun, probably, but... oh boy. I'm gonna just keep doing that. Wrecked. I don't really want to walk all the way back to, where those regen areas are, so... I'm just gonna use the rest of my potions, pretty much. I guess you can't surprise attack an eagle. They're way up above you. It's so high. Okay, I'll not attempt to sing again. Got me a level up. Oh, yeah. Pretty. I was remembering that puzzle. It looks way more intimidating than it actually is. Nothing behind the vines. Oh, goddamn. Oh, Eagle Bro got wrecked. They must only have, like, 28 HP or something like that. Back here. Oh my god. Elusive. Huh. Sort of just juked me out. Ribbit, ribbit! A rapier? Thank you. One sec. I remember this one. Miracles are sort of like Phoenix Downs in Final Fantasy. Except probably even, I don't think you can buy them in shops. 69, that son of a gun. Yeah, somewhere between 26 and 29 health. Getting pretty strong now, so pretty much just run through. Oh my, it's more than I thought there would be. If you poison me, I'd be pissed. Yeah, 26 is not gonna cut it. That had to be like eight monsters in a row. Somewhere around there. Forces you to level up. I'm gonna use this again. Okay, so it's not even 27 health. What was that again? Right. Okay. Raise my defense and my agility. I feel like I need to go get some potions before I run into the catfish boss. I didn't get either of them. You gotta be yoking me. I think that's the last door I've not been in, so it was locked, so I need to figure it out from up here. I think I remember which one it is. One-shotted. Oh, I'm not even close to the next level. Oh no, oh no. There we go, that is exactly what I needed. You check that situation out. Wow. That's pretty lucky. Rib it twice. No, I don't need to go back there. Healing up. I don't think I'm gonna get that level up before I face the boss. Oh, there we go. Wow, 23? He did 30 last time. that mouse. No. I guess it'll just go away over time. I'm not sure. 373 gold, now 1,000. Grinding up that gold. You know what? I'm gonna try and... 23 again. This dude must be just tougher than the other eagles. Poor badass. If I go up and fight these two, I should be able to get the next level. Ugh, 3 gold away, or 3 experience away. Here we go, level up. It'll be a while before my next one, though. Okay. There we go. Oh, let's see. I have one potion for this. Yeah, it's definitely a boss room. Equip the battle knife. Or the IP attack. Causing me another earthquake. Maybe I will. Bored catfish. You're pretty freaking big for a catfish in the middle of a cave. Yeah, 40 damage. Pretty substantial. We'll just keep doing that. Until I can't anymore. Oh, holy shit. I hope he does not do that again. Because I literally don't have enough healing to withstand that again. I hope I kill him on this. Oh. I think I might. I literally have to kill him on this one. Oh, thank God. Living life on the edge there. Yeah, go back to bed. Ponder what you've done. Wonder how you've gotten so big. Was definitely what's that button? There we go. Stick you with an arrow. Cut through here. I should probably equip the stronger item again. Oh, and I have boom. 5 HP. Not gonna kill me now. Da 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 told her he wants to lick it. Oh, yeah. Good old Tia came for me. I maxed out all my items. No, cap. There we go. I'm gonna go to the magic store though. Get some good old fashioned magic. Yeah, strong is your basic healing spell. Spark, fireball, water attack. Get the healing spell. There we go. I guess I'll go heal. Save. Quick, I'm just gonna... I'll probably edit this out, but I'm gonna check if I actually have any viewers. I kinda doubt I do, but... Viewers. No followers, no viewers. I'm popular. Okay, there we go. Raise the water level again. How's it going? Yeah. Do a little bit of damage. No problem. And I just couldn't help myself. Silly me, you're not going anywhere, right, Maxim?
No, bitch.
Yep. He's like, but I'm the chosen one. Come on, no. Uh-huh.
That light was... has an evil power that could lead to the world's destruction. That's what I was told by some random lady in a cave, and I chose to believe her. That lady also told me to jump off a bridge. Also don't seem to have parents.
I'm going with you. Yeah, you just begged me. Yes, you just begged us.
Heh
I'm probably leveling almost too fast in this, but... I'm gonna go... I think there's at least a whip I could give her. Do you ever see an item in a shop that's like... not for you, and you're the only party member, you're like, oh, I'm gonna get someone new soon. Get her. Keeps your hair off your face. Yeah. You can do that with, like, a scrunchie or something like that. I don't really care about that. Got two. Can't remember if she... I think she has some spells. Yeah, she has... I'll get her drop wood also. She's sort of your spellcaster, so... it's got a nice little snap to it, I like it. Maxim's gonna be so overleveled compared to Tia. That's... possibly gonna kill all of them. Yep. It's like, just don't want to deal with all of those. Moon's Kingdom. I do know something up here that some people might not originally see, so I'm gonna go try to get that first. Yeah, Fumi Woods. Fumi! Little Clad Dude. Or Foam Dude. Shells. Nah. I would name him Nimbus, but I'm gonna just name him Nimbu. Don't quite have enough. I think that's a good name. So, capsule monsters, they're sort of like Pokemon. You can level them up also, but you can also feed them certain items and whatnot to level them, to evolve them. Like, I don't have the item it's currently craving, but I have 4 chop boards, so I can, like... some of them have pretty particular tastes. Like, I'm not ever gonna use those items, so might as well... they normally like items with IP associated with them. See, there's my little buddy over there. You can't control what they do, but they're actually pretty strong. Depending on, they have abilities they can use, like, this dude has, like, Fumi Punch, which can do quite a bit of damage. Old Nimbu. I should have just named him Boo. Uh-oh, he had 666. Nice little town here. I think I'm probably gonna save here and stop for now, because I'm getting hungry. And then I'll be back at some point. Later this afternoon, probably.